So I'm about to review Die Hard on Nintendo, but before I begin, I think I need to address the kind of disturbing, maybe offensive nature of the front cover. What does this remind you of? It's kind of, you know, it's a little, let's carry on.
So this game's gonna be good, or is it gonna suck? We'll take a wild fucking guess. So this is the first enemy in the game, and I can't even get near him because he's shooting bullets all over the place and running away like an asshole. Get back here, you fucker. Come on! Ah, I missed. Oh, now there's another guy already? God, I can't move! Now I'm out of bullets? Are you for real? Well, now if you get near him, I'm gonna punch the shit out of him. Come on, come on, all right, your mother, come on, come on, fuck you up, come on! You know, is his other arm paralyzed or something? What's going on? Well, come on, you motherfucker, come on, you motherfucker, come on! Yeah, done. And how sad is this? I only killed one guy in the game so far, and I'm almost dead. And once you're dead, the game's over, and you start back from the beginning. But at least they got the goddamn courtesy to give you a life bar. Anyway, let's take a look at the status screen so I can try my best to explain the object of this game. Well, you can see there's 39 crooks. I'm under the impression that means there's 40 bad guys in the game, and your goal is to hunt and kill all of them. And that's nearly impossible when one guy can take all your life. That's kind of interesting. You don't usually get to know how many guys you're gonna kill. Imagine if in Super Mario Brothers there's a counter telling you exactly how many Goombas and Koopa Troopas are in the entire game. Only difference, you don't have to kill them all. Alright, so you got your life bar, which is self-explanatory. Then you got a feet bar. Yeah, your feet have power too, right? You can run by holding the B button, but that drains your foot power. Now, let me ask a question. What's the difference between saving your foot power and using it to get your ass moving? Is it better to run and waste your foot power, or just walk slow and waste your fucking time? Also, if you walk over broken glass, that also drains your foot power. And I can see where they're going with this. In the movie Die Hard, John McClane's feet end up in pretty bad shape, and by the end of the movie, he's limping. Now, that's nice that they tried to make it like a movie, but there's sometimes when you should do that, and sometimes when it's really not necessary. That's like if in Lethal Weapon, if you're going around eating dog biscuits for power-ups. So let me finish up with all this shit. You got your weapons, the items you pick, and I don't know, some math that doesn't make any sense. Then you got some weird lock system. After a certain amount of time passes, one of the locks activates or whatever. And when all these locks activate, I assume you're dead. But why not just have a clock with a simple time limit? I don't know. So you can break glass, which is cool, but you can't walk over without draining your foot power, so it's not cool. Then you got outside windows, which you think would have some kind of purpose, but no, you just jump out and die. What's the point? Why would you commit suicide unless you don't have a clue what you're doing? It's a beginner's trap. Now what I really hate is this darkness thing. You can't see around any of the walls. Half the time there's nothing going on, he's walking around, and he walks like there's something wrong with him. He's got like one leg. So you're just going around, and then all of a sudden you're dead, and you don't even see it coming. You can't even scratch your head, you'll just be playing, and all of a sudden, whoa, you're dead. The power-ups are soda cans, and the best part of the game is the vending machine, because you can just shoot the soda out of them, and you don't need it to stay alive. You can also find first aid kits to heal some of your foot power, and you can pick up flash grenades, which are supposed to stun your enemies, but I've never once been able to hit anybody with one of these damn things. And besides, why would you want to stun them when you can just take them out with a bullet? So there's a beginner and advanced mode, and from what I noticed, there's no difference except that the advanced mode starts you off at any random floor, where in the beginner mode, you always start on the 32nd floor. Now, let's talk about the floors. It seems you can go to any floor you want, anytime you want, that is between 31 and 35. You can use the elevators, the stairs, or even the air ducts. But how do you know where you're supposed to go? I don't know, I just find guys and kill them. There's supposed to be hostages on the 30th floor, but for whatever reason, you can't go there yet, so I'm guessing that happens at the end. But anyway, if you go up to the 35th floor, there's a guy who has a key to the roof. But finding him is a real bitch, because he never wants to show up until you've already tried the locked door a million times. But once you find him, you're obviously gonna take a lot of bullets, because there really isn't any way to dodge in this narrow hallway. Die! That's kind of weird, he's like dead in the doorway. But anyway, you take the key, you unlock the door, you go to the roof, and, well, this is the roof. Sometimes when you get here, John McClane calls the cops, and sometimes he doesn't. It's like in the movie, and I don't know if it's necessary or affects anything in the game, but it doesn't even seem like you have any control over it, so it really doesn't fucking matter. Somewhere up here there's a rope, which I don't know if it's important or not. You blow up this gym locker or whatever it is, and then he says, I'd have to be desperate to tie that one and jump off. No thanks. Are you kidding me? Have you ever had a video game character talk back to you and say, no, I'm not gonna do that. Going back to Mario again. What if Mario just said, you know, I'm really not feeling up to jumping over that platform? No thanks. This is ridiculous. I mean, he won't climb down with a rope, but he'll jump out a window and fucking kill himself? So I'm taking the stairs down, now I find some blueprint of the 5th floor. Whoa, now we're talking about the 5th floor? Take out the main computer? I'm getting confused. So I'm going around trying to kill people and Officer Carl Winslow keeps talking to me. So I'm just walking around, waiting for whatever random stuff to happen. Then the police car blows up, I'm like, what does this have to do with anything? Then Steve Urkel comes on, I'm like, what the fuck? The graphics don't even make any sense. I don't even know what anything is supposed to be. What's this? What's that? Seriously, what the shit is this thing? What the shit is it? I just can't figure this out. This is like one of those games that you need a manual or read somebody's walkthrough on the internet. But when it gets to that, it's like, who cares? I'd rather have a mountain lion dump its ass all over my face. I'd rather unclog a shitty toilet with my bare hands. You know, I'm not fucking around anymore. Forget trying to explain how this game works. Let's just fucking do it. Back here, you motherfucker. Get back here. Look at all these bullets. Fuck. The control is so stiff. You can only shoot straight or at a 45-degree angle. There's guys around every corner. There's guys coming out of the elevator. There's guys coming out of your ass. Crazy.